Hello everybody, my name is Leo and in this video we will share a demo review of the much awaited Hot Tone Ampero 2 Stomp. First of all, we will hear the unit in action with a double demo song, then we will describe the main characteristics of the unit, also comparing it to similar amp modeling pedalboards. Then we will hear more sounds in the more sound section of this video, and finally, as usually, I will give you my 2 cents. So I hope you enjoy, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell, as it would really help me to make more videos like this. Let's start! Now describe the Ampero Stomp 2. First of all, which are its main competitors? I would say that for the price they are the Podgo, the GE250 and the MX5. And in terms of form factor, I would mention the Line 6 HX Stomp and the Boss GT1000 Core. Let's talk about the form factor. The dimensions are 185 by 145 by 58 millimeters, and it weighs 1.08 kilos. Not having the expression pedal, it is obviously smaller than the Podgo, the G250 and the MX5. On the other hand, it is a little bit bigger and heavier than the HX Stomp and the GT1000 Core, but it has a much bigger screen, as we will see later on. In terms of robustness, it feels pretty sturdy, even if we need time to verify the robustness of the unit and many tests playing on the road. It has 3-foot switches, so less than the G250 and the PodGo, and in line with the MX5, the HX Stomp and the GT1000 Core. This is a cons versus, for instance, the PodGo, but it has both MIDI in and out, and therefore you can use external controllers, like for instance the Ampero control. The 3-foot switches can be used to activate or bypass single effects blocks with amps or effects, as well as to select presets. Like the HX Stomp and the GT1000 Core, it is missing the expression pedal, and if you want, you can attach one via the XP input. I am totally fine with this choice, as I am not a heavy user of volume pedals, and if I want, I can attach one. It has a 4-inch color screen, where the PodGo, the MX5 and the G250 are respectively 4 inches and 3.5 inches. It is touch sensitive, as the MX5, but it has also a computer app that is missing in the MX5. And well, the screen of the HX Stomp and especially the GT1000 Core are jokes compared to the one of the Ampero Stomp 2. All in all, the overall user experience using the Stomp 2 is pretty good, I would say. It has 87 amp simulation, with one specifically dedicated to a power amp, where you can, for instance, select the power amp valves that you want to use. This is a pretty cool feature, as you can use the unit, for instance, paired with your favorite preamp, like the Victory V4 or the Synergy Modus. It has 68 cabinets, where 8 are dedicated to the bass guitar. It offers 10 microphones, where 6 of them are mixed mics, like an SM57 plus a Royer 1-to-1. So here the Stomp excels, both in terms of number of amps and cabs, but also in terms of features. I mean, that power amp only simulation and the double mics are pretty cool, very nice tools to shape our tone and to pair the Stomp, for instance, with our favorite valve preamps, like the Victory V4 or the Synergy Modus. It offers almost 180 effects that you can arrange in 12 serial blocks, amp and cab included, or you can arrange in 2 rows of 6 independent parallel effects, or you can mix the 2 options, with some effects in series and some other in parallel. You can also load 2 amps at the time. So the signal chain is pretty flexible, and I think we are gonna do a specific video showing what you can do with the Ampero Stomp 2 signal chain. I think that it is second only to the GT1000 Core that has a crazy number of blocks and allows you to build pretty complex signal chains. Summarizing, it offers a pretty large number of amps, it has a power amp module that, as I said previously, allows you to couple the unit with the real valve preamps. It offers combination of mics, for instance with an SM57 and a Royer 1-to-1. You have 12 blocks of effects with the possibility to build parallel effects. That are the factors that allow this unit to shine and where the value for money start to become pretty evident in my opinion. You have 30 IRs already loaded, with IRs dedicated to acoustic guitar, to bass cabinet and obviously to guitar cabinet. You can also load your own IRs in 50 user slots. You can load IRs up to 2048 sample points. It has an 8x8 USB audio interface that supports sampling rate up to 44.1 kHz at 24 bits, and the dynamic range is 127 dB, which is a pretty high value. For reference, the Zoom G6 has 123 dB and the G250 has 100 dB. So here the dynamic range is pretty impressive, and the 8x8 audio interface allows us to create flexible routing with our computer. My only complaint here is that you cannot record at 48 kHz, but the unit is limited to 44.1, and I typically record at 48 kHz. As regards the looper, you can run 60 seconds stereo looper, and as far as I understood, it does not offer an included drum machine. Let's now have a look at the I/O. It has a double input, so basically you can connect two instruments like a guitar and a bass, or a stereo source like a keyboard. Then you have an expression pedal input and balanced stereo output via TRS cable. Finally, still on the back of the unit, you have the power input, and the unit can run at 9 volts or 18 volts to have a greater dynamic range. On the side, you have regular MIDI ports with a USB Type-C port. Thank you, Otone, for using Type-C instead of Type-B, as the Type-C is reversible and so much more comfortable to be used. On the other side, we have a stereo FX loop via TRS cable and headphone out and an aux in. So here we have one of the most advanced units in comparison with its main contenders, offering balanced stereo out, stereo FX loop, regular MIDI ports and stereo inputs. So that's all as regards the description of the unit, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell in order not to miss my upcoming videos, where we will make detailed comparisons of the Otone Ampero versus its main competitors, also comparing the sound of the unit versus real amps. Let's now hear some more sounds. my considerations here, and please notice that these are gonna be my personal opinions and you may not agree with me, and this is totally fine. Furthermore, Otone has sent me this unit for free, but they are not asking me to say anything, and I am not paid to make this video. Therefore, I'm free to tell you whatever I want. Let's have a look at the pros and cons of the unit. The pros. First of all, the connectivity. I mean, it offers at the same time balanced output, stereo effect loop, and MIDI connectivity. Then I would mention the versatility. In fact, thanks to its connectivity and, for instance, to its power amp simulation, it can be used in many different ways. It can be the only unit you bring with you for playing, or it can be paired with your favorite preamp, or it can be just the centerpiece of your standard pedalboard. And thanks to its 8 USB channels, it can be also the center point of your recording studio. The third pro is the signal chain, as it offers the possibility to load pretty complex chains with parallel effects, which is something not all the other competitors are offering. Even, for instance, being able to load 2 amps at the same time. As regards the sound, well, it sounds pretty good, with tons of possibilities, like, as I said, the double microphones, or the possibility to load 2 amps, or the full package of IRs included with the Celestion ones, etc. And you can judge the quality of the sounds from the more sound section of this video or the demo song. And, of course, in future videos we will go deep on this topic, also comparing it to other amp modeling pedalboard and to real tube amps. So don't forget to subscribe. I would mention only one cons, the missing 48 kHz support for recording. And then it would be nice to have the setlist, like in the MX-5, or the scenes, like in the MG-30, or the Line 6 amp modeling pedalboards. But maybe these features will come with future firmware upgrade. All in all, well, I'm pretty impressed by the value for money of this unit. In this price range, I think this is a unit pretty hard to beat, and with the support for 48 kHz, it would have been almost perfect. So that's all for this video. I'm really curious to hear your opinions. What do you think about the Stomp 2? Would you buy it over its main contenders, or would you prefer the HX Stomp or the GT1000 Core? Please let me know your precious and valuable opinions in the comment below. And subscribe if you don't want to miss my detailed direct comparisons with the Stomp 2 and other amp modeling pedalboards. We have now reached the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did it, please subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and leave a thumbs up to be of a great help. If you're interested in my IRs or in my camper profiles, you can check out the link in the card above or description below, where there is also a link to a playlist of songs of mine. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.